of you at the dam site to know the dam and various parts of the dam. We are here at Malgi, a dam constructed for the Dharma river. You can see this dam is an earthen dam. There are so many types of dams. You can have the RCC dam also, and you can have the masonry dam and earthen dam. This is one type of the dam, that is earthen dam. So what is the purpose of making the earthen dam?
Store the water.
If the dam is too long, irrigation purpose. Earthen dam is because if you are having enough soil nearby, suitable soil, you can use the soil which is nearby, and at low cost you can construct the dam. That's the main purpose of using the earthen dam. There are so many varieties of earthen dam. This is a homogeneous type of earthen dam. Homogeneous type. If you are going to find out its slope, slope is nearly 3:1 on one side, other side it is again 3:1. Very flat slope is given. The purpose is earthen dam. If it is having any core wall inside, that slope you can reduce. Puddle core wall you can have, or a masonry core wall inside if you can have, then you can reduce the slope. Possibility is there. What is the purpose of giving the core and all? You are not supposed to allow the water to come out through the body of the dam. It should not seepage, should not happen through the body. That is the main purpose. Okay? So now, on one side you are having the area where you are going to store the water. Okay, here you can see on the right side. Other side area is there. This is a irrigation purpose dam. It is not a multi-purpose. Irrigation water supply. You can see there the structure which is constructed to supply the water for the drinking purpose. Other side you can see 1, 2, 3 canals. One is stream, original stream, and two canals and two sluices are there. Okay, this is also one of the tank sluice. Another tank sluice you can see there. So, how do you make the location of the dam? Somebody has found out that this is the very suitable area to make this particular dam, so that they can store the water, and rain is there, so that water will be stored in the rainy season, and after that, after the rainy season, you can start supplying the water to the canal system. That's why they found this suitable, and enough catchment area is there. You can see catchment area, it makes a basin, and a reservoir type of thing can be done. Then systematically using the canal, sluice, etc., you can supply the water to the other side, command area. Command area is the area whatever you can see on the other side, but you should have the cultivable command area. Understood? Cultivable command area means what actually? Wherever you can cultivate. That's called as cultivable command area. Very, very important. So, depending upon how much cultivable command area you are having and how much rainfall is there here, that is going to decide the height of the dam. You can see here, lot of thousands of trucks, lakhs of trucks of soil is to be actually dumped and rolled layer by layer to make this particular dam. Am I right?
Yes.
To make up to their top end level, it is so difficult, and you have to see the OMC. OMC means what? Optimum moisture content. At that optimum moisture content, you have to roll. Okay, at proper water, then only it will be very much compacted. Like that you have to bring, then only it will be impervious type of structure. Understood? So you can, what saturation gradient and all, you can make it steeper if you are going to make like that. Understand? That's why the rolling etc. must be proper at OMC layer. The specified thickness only you have to roll properly, then only you can get a good body of the earthen dam. It is very, very important to have a very good stable dam. If you are having seepage etc., there will be a problem. Okay, now you concentrate on the upstream side, which are the various levels. You should know dam should be constructed in such a way that anytime water is not flowing above this. The reason is it is an earthen dam. Am I right? It is an earthen dam. If it start flowing above this, what happens? You are going to, the soil is going to be what?
Eroded,
isn't it? Then dam will collapse. Breaching is called as a breaching of dam. For that, you are supposed to do proper arrangements. Okay, here, what are the arrangements so that water is not going that side? What arrangement you can see here? Can you tell me? During the rainy season, when the tank is constructed like this or the dam is constructed like this, water should not flow above the dam. How we are going to make sure it's not happening? That's very important. How do you fix the TBL, top bund level? What are the various important points you are supposed to consider the top bund level? And what are the arrangements you are supposed to make the dam very safe? And what are the arrangements you are supposed to make the dam is useful for some purposes, which is actually it is constructed? So that, let's see all those things. Okay, here, which are the various structures which are associated with the dam? First of all, you should know the purpose why those particular structures are being used in the case of a dam. See here, dam body is constructed, then water is stored on other side, it will become a reservoir, and you should ensure that during the rainy season, okay, after certain level is the dam is filled up, which is normally called as a full tank level. You are going to fix certain dam height as the full tank level, depending upon what height of the dam as well as the water, how much it is going to be stored here. You are going to make the dam full tank level, which depends upon the water requirement of the crops also. Understood? So full tank level you are going to fix. Okay, so once you fix the full tank level, in this particular case you can say from there, if it is around 10 meters full tank level, if you are fixing like that, FTL is full tank level is 10 meters. If think like that, so all of you see here, full tank level when you fix it, how do you ensure that during the heavy rain, water again will not raise and will come to the top and it is going to flow above the water, that above the dam? How do you ensure that? See, extra water after the tank is full during rainy season, it is possible. Am I right? Once it is full, they say after 1 month or 1.5 months, your dam level, full tank level is reached. After that also rain is, there will be heavy rain, you say. Okay. Then how do you make sure that water is not coming above? For that purpose, excess water you are supposed to leave. Understand? Excess water. There are so many methods to leave the excess water. Okay. Depending on the quantity of water which is stored and coming, inflow is there in the dam. What are you going to do? Excess water or surplus water above a particular level, okay, you want to take it out on the other side. Systematically, you have to use a weir, which is a strong area. Understand? Not same height, lower height. Understand? Lower than the dam height, if you are providing some area, some length of the body of the dam, so that excess water during the rainy season, after the full tank level has reached in the reservoir, it should go out, means you are supposed to give a surplus weir. It's called a surplus weir, surplus escape. Okay, then it is weir itself, you are having vertical drop, and you can have a oogie weir. There are so many varieties, depending on the shape is given the name. Okay, so you are supposed to give a weir. Weir is what? On the dam, you cannot take, other dam, you cannot take the water and make it drop other side. It should be strong, a weir wall should be strong, on which water can flow. Understood? A wall should be constructed. So this is the dam, a wall you have to construct. Systematically, you are supposed to give an abutment on one side, other side, then give the wing walls, like this, four wing walls you give systematically. Then give a wall at lower level, at the full tank level, okay? Full tank level you give a wall, above that water will flow, which will not, water will not come above the what, dam. Understood? That is the purpose. So a systematically arranged area in a dam to leave the water, surplus water from the reservoir side to the downstream side, is called a weir. That is one of the structure in case of the dam. in this dam also you are having a weir at the last end, on the right side end you are going to have a weir, so that extra water above particular level it goes out, and then the dam is safe. Understand? Dam will be safe then only. Okay, that's one structure and its purpose. You understood? A dam, a weir which is at the lower level, when you, that is full tank level is over, then water you are supposed to take to other side. So it is called as the surplus escape or surplus weir. Okay, that is one of the structure, very important structure.
Is the tank sluice. What do you mean by tank sluice? Tank purpose is to store the water and distribute the water or to supply the water to the field, am I right?
Yes.
Isn't it? You are supposed to supply the water through the canal system. Now sluice is what? From the reservoir, systematically, you are supposed to take the water from the upstream side to downstream side to the canal. Okay, the canal, you should have the water from the reservoir, then you are supposed to make this sluice. Sluice is basically a pipe, that's all. Okay, you fix a pipe from this side to that side, it will go, water will go when there is water, am I right? Isn't it?
Yes.
Height of the water is more, means more pressure it will go. More pressure it will go to other side. Am I right? So, here, this particular dam, you can see, this is one sluice here, tank sluice, that's other tank sluice. Why two tank sluice here? This one is actually at the higher RL, higher contour. Meaning is what? Higher contour means the area which is at higher level, also it can take the water. Understand? Maybe around the difference between those two is around some 4 meters. Whatever area, irrigable area, 4 meter above also, this can take the water. Understand? One sluice. Understand? So when there is full, tank is at the, water is at the higher level, you can use this one. Tank, water is at higher level, you can use this particular sluice. Then it goes down like this. You can see here. Now the level has gone down. The water level has gone down. Okay. Then you can use that one and it can irrigate not the higher level area. The lower level area it can irrigate systematically. Am I right? It will flow, it will take the water to the other side and you can supply to the, yes, cultivable command area you can supply, which is reachable to that level. Understood? That level below whatever it is, it can supply. So like that, at various levels you can give the sluices. Understand? Now sluice can be given even to the original river. This particular reservoir is for a particular river, Dharma river. Understand? Now this is the reservoir. The river will not be that much wide actually. It will be somewhat narrow than this. Somewhere there it was flowing. Original river also we can give the sluice so that water from this side goes. Gate, somebody is telling gate, you can lift the gate so that it goes to the original river which is existing, Dharma river. Understood? Here they have made the sluice for that. Third sluice they have made so that if they lift the gate, it will go to other side. Now, for example, if you are taking a particular sluice like this, what are the things you should have? It's very, very important. This particular sluice, first thing, you should have a pipe, am I right? You should have a pipe. In the estimation also, you may be having this particular syllabus. You are having a dam like this, am I right? Correct, now dam section. You are taking section now. It is having a slope. You can start from there, ground, bed level, you can say there. Bed level, slope, TBL, top end level. Okay, width, then again slope, then ground level. Like that you are having the section, am I right? Correct, na? So now, if water is there, if you connect with a pipe, it will go other side. A slope should give. Need not give slope also because pressure is there, means it will go. Understood? So, if you are giving a pipe from here to here, simply a pipe giving is not sufficient. Understand? How much water should go through the pipe should be controlled. You require a proper control. Am I right? For that, some control, mechanical control arrangements, just like tap control you do, depending upon the water requirement of the various seasons, various timings, in the beginning prop may require more, less and all to supply that. To economically use the water, you have to appropriately use the
mechanical device which will allow the water to other side more or less in the canal. More or less water can be actually supplied through the sluice. Okay, now for example, sluice is having around 30 centimeter diameter. Maybe here 30 centimeter diameter sluice is there. A sluice can be a circular sluice in the section, it can be rectangular also. Understand, sluice can be either, it can be rectangular, it can be constructed. Concrete construction you can do, like the rectangular also you can have sluice, so that it will take the water from this side to other side, rectangular. It can be a circular one, a pipe, understood? So you can take from one side to other side, it will take the water from one side to other side. Now, you are supposed to make proper arrangement for that. A particular opening is there means you should give, because it is in the slope. It is in the slope, am I right? So what are the protections you are supposed to make? You are supposed to make arrangement for the water to enter the sluice. Proper arrangement, you can see the walls there. Can you see there? You should have the wing walls so that into the sluice water is guided. It is called as the what? Wing wall. One wing wall that side, one wing wall this side, and for the sluice a protective wall like this. If you are in head wall, you can call it as head wall. So three basic elements are there: sluice, one pipe, one vertical wall for that, one side wall, and one this side wall. If you are giving, water properly enters without disturbing the soil mass of the embankment, am I right? This is the soil mass embankment, otherwise it will be taken with the what? Water. Water, flowing water is having a lot of energy, and the soil and all it don't care. That's why proper protection is to be given, so that entry speed will be more, entering its speed will be more. Normally water will be having more speed. Understood? Entry speed will be more. That's why proper guidance with protected walls, so that your embankment is not going to be diffused or it is going to be disturbed later on. Understood? It is for, and see why these things are to be given is not for one day, it is. It's for thousand, maybe 50 years, 100 years, like that it has to work. Am I right? More than that actually. More than that. So many hundreds of years it has to work. That's why systematically once only you are supposed to do. Lot of care you have to take, lot of protection you have to take, more than required you may feel. But you have to do it. Vertical wall, wing walls, etc. Understood? This is an arrangement which will allow a person to go there and operate that. Okay? When you will be operating, when it is not given, when it is not given down, why it is not given down is, this should be above the maximum water level. What do you mean by the max full tank level and maximum water level? Can you tell me? What is the difference between maximum water level is what, full tank level is what, and top end level is what? Three levels are very, very important for us. Top end level is that level. Understand? You can see that is the TBL. Top end level. This is the bund. It is the top of the bund. Top end level. You can see that is the top end level. Almost same. Normally, normal. It's same. What is full tank level? Can you tell me what is full tank level? Tank is full. Okay, it will start flowing, overflowing. So that level is fixed at certain depth. Surplus sewer. Okay, sewer, all of you. Surplus sewer top. That wall, surplus is a wall, as I told you. Top of that one is actually full tank level. Understand? Above that, water flow. See, above that, what depth it follows? Maximum. The highest water is in the rain has happened in this area. Highest rain has happened in this area. And maybe around 25 years or 30 years, that is the maximum rain. During that dam, at what height above that it is going to flow? Maybe if you are having at 94 is your full tank level, just think. 94 is the full tank level. Okay. In the year, highest rain has happened here. At that time, it is flowing above that 1 meter. Highest rainfall in this area, water coming in and flowing is 1 meter height above the, which one? Above the full tank level is flowing. So now, that 1 meter level is flowing now. That full tank level is 94. Your maximum water level is what? 95. Understand? 95. Okay. 95. Now, dam height TBL should be much above that, which one? Maximum water level.
full tank level, the height of at which the water flows during the heaviest rain, that is maximum water level. Then above that, free board you should have, maybe around 2 meters. Maybe around 2 meters, you can calculate here, TBL. This is the maximum water level, some 30 centimeters above maximum water level is kept. This level is kept at, you can see here, that is kept 30 centimeters above the maximum water level. Because when maximum water level is there, then you have to operate this. Understood? They have to operate during maximum water level also, that's why it's kept around 30 centimeters above that. Understood? Full tank, I think here your free board is around 3 meters or 2.5 meters here, you can see. Understood? That is maximum water level. From there, 30 centimeter below will be maximum water level. Then around 3 meters, 3.3 meter I think is the TBL above that. Now TBL will be according to us 94 plus 3.3 meter. How much it is? 9. Maximum water level 3.3 meter. How much it is? 97.3. Isn't it? Full tank level is 94. Maximum water level is 1 meter. Okay. Above that 3.3. Remember, full tank level is how much? 94. Above that? 3. Above that 1 meter is maximum water level. Then above that? 3.3 meters top end level. That much of difference will be kept. Understand? Okay. Understood. That 1 meter if you want to reduce, that it should not come 1 meter above. What is the idea? Can you tell me? 1 meter in the kadame, it should be 50 centimeter. What is the idea? What you have to do? Length of the weir you have to increase. Am I right? So whatever weir, some 50 meter you might have given. Understood? 50 meter length you have given, 1 meter is flowing. Make it 100 meter, okay? Make it 100 meter, it will come 50 centimeter, am I right? Because area, total of flow area will be same. Understood? Correct, na? 50 meter, has to 1 meter hogta itu, neeru. So same water, it has to go with a 50 centimeter height. Then, what you have to do? Length you increase, weir length you increase. Then, what is the total height required, the dam height required now? Length of the dam, just think, what happens now? TBL is reduced means what? Now TBL is 50 centimeter. Your maximum water level is reduced by 50 centimeter. This complete length of the dam, okay, some 3.5 kilometers, 2 kilometers will be reduced by 50 centimeter. What is the meaning of that? So cost. Your weir, if you by adjusting the weir maximum water level adjustment, you can reduce the lot of cost in the dam. Very, very important. Understand? Got it? Lot of cost you can reduce depending on that. Understood? Adjustment of that one. Okay? Not only that, sometimes you can give extra gates, etc., areas to float, other side also. It's also possible. Basic, this is the basic. This is a basic requirement in a particular dam. Now, three levels you understood. This is riprap or it is pitching you are going to give. You can see stones pitching. Up to maximum water level, just above maximum water level should be given. Just above the maximum, see this is the maximum water level, it should be given just above that on the upstream side. It should protect, am I right? Normally how it is given with these stone pieces, understood? Below that some sand is given, sand bed, and above that stone is being built. Sand acts as a actually drainage, it is going to act as a drainage strata and a layer. Then you are going to put the or 20 centimeter sand will be given. Above that, you are going to give the pitching stone. You are going to properly arrange to protect this side, because water and soil should not come directly in contact. And normally, it will have some waves. You can see small waves will be there. It will be hitting, and that's a possibility of disturbance to the slope, whatever the systematic slope what you are given on the upstream side. Understand? Okay, you got it. So these are very, very important aspects in the particular case. Now, controlling devices here, how you can control this one? There are various types. Okay, this is a wall. You are having a wall in the front, then you are lifting and opening. Lifting and opening. So half closed, quarter closed, full open, like that you can make. Understood? Half open, full open, that particular. So you can open it. Understand? Then water accordingly it will go. Just like tap opening. yes, discharge will go to other side, depending on that. Now you can have a tower head also, control device also. Understood? Tank switch. Tower head tank switch means you can have a well here. Understood? A well type thing you can have. Okay, well type thing you can have. Above that, some control arrangement you can do. In a wall and a plate. Here, what is that? A wall and a plate, directly sluice is there. Now, give the pipe and here, you make a hole. And that to the pipe, here you close and open. Make a hole here, just like a well. Okay, in the top you can keep. Here you can cover. Up to that you can cover. Here it's exposed. You can see there. Okay, small arrangement you can do at the end. But here, in the middle also, middle of the slope also you can, what? Yes, make well. Near. After this one also you can make well. After your maximum water level also you can make well. Near to this. Understood? Here, I can make a well. Here, I can control. Possibility is there. It's called as tower head type. It's called as the? A well you make exactly above the pipe, control it from there, from that well. That is also tower head type of water tank. There is a sluice, tank sluice. Understand? These are the very important basic types of the tank sluices. Okay, now regarding the head walls, this is a head wall, that side also head wall will be there. So that side you are going to have the canal. Some explanation, canal I will give there only, in the canal only. Understood? Some explanation other side you have to see canal. How is it and how the, what are the important types of the canals? What are the canal in cutting, canal in filling, partially cutting, etc. So what are the various levels in the canal also you should understand. Some 5 minutes of explanation will be there that side. Okay, all of you? What's the time now?
12:18.
You can see sluice here maybe around 40 centimeter diameter. You can see it is half closed. See, rectangular cast iron, that closing arrangement is here. From the top it can be rotated, it can be lifted. Whenever the water is there, full water is there, full tank level is there, or maximum water level is there, it can be operated, and extra water can be left other side. That also you can do. Irrigation purpose, whatever, whenever it's required, you can use the sluice and control. You can control the flow of water in the canal. Understand? Okay. This is a circular type of this sluice which is provided, and it is calculated. See here, you have done in the laboratory the flow of water through the sluice and all. The purpose is this one only. Ide, in adhuvalla. Why it is done? Sluice only. Circular sluice only. Hege water flow, the formulas and all you are having. Am I right? We are having the formula flow through that and the coefficient of discharge. ಅದನ್ನ ಯಾಕೆ ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಲ್ಯಾಬಲ್ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕಲ್ಲ, ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರೋದು. ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್. ಅಂಡ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್? ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಸ್ಲೂಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಇನ್ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್. ದಿಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಇಫ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಡೂ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್, ವೈ ದಿಸ್ ವಾಲ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್, ಮೇಕ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್, ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್. ವಾಟ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್, ಒನ್ ವಾಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಗುಡ್, ಆಮ್ ರೈಟ್? ದೆನ್ ಟೂ ವಿಂಗ್ ವಾಲ್ಸ್ ಯು ಗಿವ್, ಟೂ ವಿಂಗ್ ವಾಲ್ಸ್ ಯು ಗಿವ್, ಒನ್ ವಿಂಗ್ ವಾಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ವಿಂಗ್ ವಾಲ್. And it's played, you can see it's called as played. Played means what? Coming down, am I right? Wall is not at same level. It is a played wing wall. It's called as the played wing wall. Okay. Isn't it? It's a played wing wall. And its the level is reducing. Okay. And one more thing to play is how much it is going from the straight line. Say this is the line like this. You are going to have horizontally, you can see 3 meter, okay, for 3 meter, 1 meter here it's going this way, sideways is going. Is the straight, am I right?
Yes.
Is the straight, if it comes like this, it's called a straight wing wall. Straight wing wall, it is not coming straight. Okay, now, it is going this way, how much it is going? Straight line, it is going 1 meter. 3 meter, 1 meter means, it is 1 in 3 split. It is called as what?
1 in 3
splay. In the drawing and all, when you are drawing, you have to use that one properly. You have to take 3 centimeters and 1 centimeter and all, you have to make like that. Splay. So it is a splayed wing wall. So why the splayed wing wall is given in case of the, in case of the water bodies, why the splayed wing wall is given? See, very nice water entry is required. Very nice water exit is required in the canal. And here, this side, very easy entry. And
other side EC exit is required. By the way of plotting this spreading wall, you are not disturbing the slope. Understood? Extra protection you want to give means you are going to give this return walls. This part of the return walls. Normally it is same level going some distance. Understood? And how much distance should go depends upon this slope also. You can see here, this slope also. This slope, how much should be there? This level also. Am I right? How much level is this from here to there? Depending upon that, this length will go. Understood? Now water when it is full, it will enter like this, it goes like this, and it's not going to disturb because when it comes here, the speed of the water will be more. Understand? Near to the sluice, it is speed is more. When speed is more, the soil will be affected if you don't give proper arrangement. So good arrangement you are supposed to make by providing a head wall, okay? Head wall, then providing a wing wall, a return wall. Returning wall is for the returning wall, return type of wall. Normally, if you are giving at the same level like that return, it's called as returning wall. Here it's called as return wall, that's all. Understood? It's called as a return wall. So length, it depends upon how much depth is here and how much slope you are going to give. Depending upon that, you are going to provide. Okay? So diameter is going to vary depending upon the how much water you are supposed to take to the other side, how much water is stocked in this also. Understood? More water is there means less diameter also, you are going to have more water other side. Why? Because pressure will be more, head will be more. Am I right? Understood? Head will be more. That's why. Now, this is designed depending upon the dimension of the canal also. Understood? The relationship is there, how much water is there, and the canal, maximum supply level of the canal, full supply level of the canal. What do you mean by full supply of the canal? Full supply level of the canal means what? So in the canal you are going to tell what? Full supply level. Meaning is what? The canal is designed for a particular water, maximum water flowing in this. Understood? So that level will be there. This is the maximum water, it will flow in this one. We cannot leave the water more than that also. Understood? Depending upon that, you are going to fix the diameter of this. Depending upon that, you are going to fix the diameter of this particular one. Okay? I think tanks will be some idea we got. The controlling arrangement, this is the vertically, this lifted through mechanical means, rotating there, mechanically it will come up and it will full open, half open, quarter open, depending upon the water requirement, you are going to open it. Understood? More water required means you have to lift more. And water should be there. Here this area water is not there because it has gone down, it has dried up. Understood? Rain is there, it will fill and it is going to be at a higher level. During that it will work, it function during that time. Understood? Actually, this is whatever you are standing now is part of the upstream wet level. What is it actually? At this particular location, that's the upstream wet level. If you take cross section, that's upstream wet level. This one is part of the upstream wet level. Understand? And this is the level upstream that is invert of the sluice. It's called as the upstream invert point. Invert point. This is upstream invert point. Understood? And canal also, you are going to have the pipe invert there also. Canal level must be there at that invert, other side. Understood? Okay, canal must be at that level. So, what is level here and gentle slope, we can provide the canal bed that side. E level low, gentle slope cut through, canal bed will be at that level only. Understand? These are the very, very important points in case of this sluice. You can provide a rectangular also. You can rectangle, you can masonry rectangular, concrete rectangular, etc. You can provide. Understood? A slab at the top. Understood? So it should take care of the pressure. Whatever the pipe you are going to give here should take the pressure of the soil below. Understood? If you take the section of that, how do you see? If you take the section of this one, that's very important. How do you, if you draw the section, how it will be on a sheet of paper? See here, all of you, this is the what? Bund. Top it is the slope. Okay, then a pipe goes like this. Am I right? A pipe goes like this, and it is having a wall, head wall, and a wing wall like this, wing wall like this. Am I right? Those things you can't see the section, but you can see the pipe thickness, diameter. You can see a diameter called top thickness, bottom thickness, two lines will go like this. Above that, the slope line will go. Understood? These are the things you are going to see. Understood? Understand? Now, I am telling you, this is the upstream bed level. Why it is not kept there? Why it is not kept at the upstream bed level? The reason is, water goes down also, it must be in a position to supply. Understood? The water. This bed level water is there. Okay. Below that also there it goes. It goes down. Understood? Then also it should come here. Understand? Need not be at the same level. Understand? If you are going to keep at that level, voice, then water at, if it is less than that level, it can't go. Am I right? Now, up to this level, water is also there. It can supply the water. That's why it is taken little below the bed. That's the bed. Am I right? That's the bed level. Little below that it is taken. So that more time you can supply the water. Understand? Understood? That's why this is a deep. You can see. There's a bed. Below that you have to give. So it looks like a canal. Am I right? Channel. It looks like a channel. So a small channel is cut on the upstream side so that lower level water goes also, you can take from that side to other side. Understood? You can supply. That's the purpose. Otherwise, you can keep at this level only. This level only. Understand? That's the bed, no? The bed level. You can keep. Okay? So have more functionality, more duration of time if you want to supply the water to other side, to the canal. It is very useful. That's why a channel is dug like this. So this is regarding something regarding the tanks, please. Any question you can ask.
First sluice. Okay, we are having the first sluice there at the higher level, other sluice at the lower level, and the first canal at the higher level. Higher contour, you can say. Okay, if you are taking the river is there actually. This is right bank canal, you can say it's the right bank of the river. River is that side, okay? Dharma river is flows like that. So it's the right bank canal, one of the right bank canal. We are having two right bank canals. Okay, it has the higher contour. This is at the higher contour and a contour canal, you can say. It is a contour canal, along the contour it goes almost. Understand? Now, what is very important in case of canal? Say, canal is designed depending upon how much water you are supposed to supply. Okay, to the irrigable area with certain limited that's very important. V is restricted. In the canal, what is restricted? V is restricted. Understood? For that purpose, what is very important? This slope, longitudinal slope, yes. You are going to have a longitudinal slope, meaning is what? Bed level here, if you take, and after on 100 meter, if you take the level, there will be some difference. It is, the notation is yes. Maybe to grow gravity, through gravity, water requires certain inclination, right? Normally it will be 1 in 1,000, 1 in 2,000, something like that. Okay, 2,000, 1 in 2,000, 1 in 1,000, and if it is actually lined canal, it is less, you require less. Understand? 1 in 2,000, 2,500 is okay. Lined canal. But if it is not lined, means earthen canal and you are going to have the soil only, it is rough enough and the velocity will be less. Understood? Anyway, we are going to steepness is required more. Steepness is required more to have the same velocity. Maybe you are going to have the actually longer slope depending on the type of the section you are going to give. Lined or unlined. That is the unlined canal. Understand? So now, what is very important? In the case of canal, canal section you are going to have three different types of sections. One is completely cutting, in the cutting, canal in cutting. This is complete in cutting. You can see, this canal is completely in cutting. Why? It is a full supply level is somewhere here. You can see, the full supply level of this canal is somewhere here. T-level. This level. Full supply level is this level. And this is the road that is your bank level, that is bank. This is canal bed level, that is bank level. Am I right? At the bank level. This is bed level. Full supply is here. So full supply is here. Bank level is above means what? With some freeboard you are having. What is the meaning of that? Bank level, ground level. Normal ground level here is called as bank level. Am I right? Normal ground level is that. This is the full supply level of the canal. Maximum water can come up to this level only. Okay. So this is freeboard. Whatever the height you are going to have from full supply level up to there is called the freeboard. That ground is a freeboard.
you're going to have this much free board. And sometimes it may not be like that. Your bank level will be lower than the canal pool supply level also. Possibility is there. Bank level is lower than this pool supply level. And so you have to get the free board. When the canal is in filling, fully filling, canal is partially filling and partially cutting, during that time it can happen. Understand? So here, this particular case, you are having the canal what? Fully in cutting. It's called, it is actually fully in cutting, full supply level is below the your ground level or the bank level. Understand? Okay. Now, when it is cutting, slow quadrating is 1:1. Normally, when the canal is in cutting, slope what you are going to have is 1:1 side slope we are going to have. Understood? See, all of you. See, you are supposed to see required Q, that is discharge required, you are going to take. Depending on that, you are going to find out the bed width, how much depth is required, side slope, all those things you are going to calculate. Am I right? You are having the trapezoidal section. This is a trapezoidal section, you can see. Bed width, side slope, like that, you are going to have the trapezoidal section. Understood? Okay. So, canal may be fully flowing always or partially. It may not be perennial also. Depending on what? How much water is available there? Up to what time? What duration of time? What is available in the reservoir, upstream reservoir? Understand? Depending on that, it will be functioning. Understand? That's very important thing in the case of the canal. You can see at the outlet also, the sluice outlet also, you're going to have inward. Same level in the canal bed level, you can see that. Inward really the canal bed level. Understood? Because they are slow and they are going to give the wing walls, either side, wing walls are there and the head wall is there. The head wall acts as vertically retaining wall, you can see. Wing wall also acts as retaining wall, am I right? Here also you are having speed wing wall. Here also you are having speed wing wall, coming down as the slope comes down. You can see, slope is coming down, wing wall also is coming down. So you can have return wall also sideways. Same purpose. Return wall also same purpose. So that you want to protect the soil and give the proper slope required. For that purpose, all these things are going to be helpful. And head wall you can see little above the slope. So that more protection will be there, little extra you are going to give. Understood? So it acts as a more protection. Understood? So soil will not slide down. Understand? It will be protected. More stable, this one, the slope we are going to have. Okay? So canal, what else you require? This is the basics of canal. Various types of canals I showed you. Long slope is very, very important. These are the slopes of the sides of the canal. Bed width is a very important thing. Side slope is important. Full supply depth is very important. Then free board is very important for the canal. Understand? In the design, these are the things which are normally, they are found out. Understand? So Q required is very important. Depending on that, your dimension will go. Right? Okay, thank you very much.